Welcome back, guys. We have already applied for a lot of companies, and trust me, we will apply for a lot more. But you know, applying is not enough. We have to get selected too, right? So for that, we have to upgrade our skill sets. So we are starting a new series of all the DAs, all the algorithms that you must know before you know you attempt an exam. So in this series, we'll cover up everything. Let it be DP, recursion, trees, graph, or anything else, anything that is required for you to get placed. Okay, so stay tuned, because once we are done with this series, you can't even imagine at which level you'll reach. Okay, so we are starting with trees, and you know, trees incorporate many multiple different concepts like graph, recursion. So in the in between, we'll also look into those concepts, so worry not. But as you know, as a icebreaker, as a starter, we have chosen trees. Okay, so in trees, basically we'll start from the basics and we'll reach a level from where we can easily solve any trees related question with ease. Okay, let it be a coding competition, let it be a placement exam, it doesn't matter, but we will be able to solve it. Okay, so there are different types of trees. There are binary tree, there are complete binary tree, there are binary search tree, and many more. But you know, for the initial, I'll just focus on binary tree. I'll start from binary tree, and after that we'll move on to binary search tree. After that we'll you know, we'll look how to convert a binary tree into AVL, all these. But it doesn't matter, because firstly we'll start from binary tree, and you know, binary tree is the very very root of this concept. So if you are able to clear this, if you are able to, you know, get a hold on this topic, we'll able to solve a lot more questions. So I'm just starting with binary tree. I hope that's not an issue. Okay. Now before we start, we must know that what a tree is, right? So in simpler words, tree is a non-linear data structure in which we can store information in hierarchical order. Okay, so like we have trees in our real life which have different levels like roots, trunks, branches, and leaves, we have a similar sort of tree in our coding life also. Okay, so I'll just show you an image for some better reference. Okay, so this is a typical binary tree. Okay, what do I mean a binary tree is that every node can have at max two child nodes. Okay, so what do I mean by child nodes? See, all these things, these A, B, C, D, E, F, all these that you see, these are known as nodes. Okay, they form up to make a tree. Okay, all these circular parts that you see, these are known as nodes. And every node can be categorized into two parts only. Either it's a parent node or either it's a child node. What is a parent node? A parent node, basically any node that has one or more child, these nodes are known as parent nodes. Okay, so F is here a parent node, and B and G are its child node. Okay, and B here is a parent node, A and D are its child node. Okay, so there's an interesting fact to note here is that, you know, F can never be a child node, F will always be a parent node. Okay, so we call F as what? We call F as a root node. This node has a special term for it, it's known as root node. Okay, and if you notice again, then this ACEH, these are basically, sorry, ACEH can never be a parent node, they will always be a child node, right? ACEH. So these nodes have a special term, and these are called as leaf nodes. They can always be, or they can only be a child node, right? So these are known as leaf nodes, right? Now, how are we going to form this data structure using you know, our coding languages? That is really simple. I'll show you it in all the three languages, because I don't know which language you are more comfortable with. Let it be C, C++, Java, or Python. Okay, so since it's just a starting, I'll just show you the code in every different language. Okay, so firstly, I'll just say for, okay, let me make it black. So firstly, I'll just show you the code for C++ or C. Okay, you can just code it in any of these. So I'll be using a data structure that is known as struct. Struct means structure. What is the use of this here? In this, with the help of this, I am able to, you know, incorporate different type of data types in a single data structure, right? So that is the use of this structure. So I'll have a int data. It can be character, it can be string. It just depends on which type of value you want to store. Okay, so int data. And after that, since I'm right now only forming a binary tree, right? So since every node can have at max two child nodes, so I need something to store the address of those child nodes, right? So that is why I have just the simple names struct node star left. This will store the value of the left child, and struct node star right. This will store the value of the right child. Okay, pretty simple, right? So this is this is basically the code for a single node. Okay, this is a code for a single node, and we can actually, you know, just connect all these multiple nodes. Suppose just for an example take, we have created a struct node f. Okay, it's int data. Let's just say that this is character. Okay, char data. So char data, I'll just give it a value of f. Okay, I'll just give it a value of f, and in its left, initially left will be null, right will be null. Okay, since this is the first node, let's just say that left will be null, right will be null. When left and right are null, it means that there is no value present in into its left or its right. So how does it help us? It basically helps us like this. Since we'll be using trees, we'll be, you know, how are we going to iterate throughout this tree? For that, we'll be using recursion. Okay, so recursion needs two things. It needs a base condition, and it needs a base condition, and how are we going to call that function again and again. So this, if this is null, this will act as a base condition. How? Since if I ever, you know, reach a node, if I ever reach a node who does not have any of the childs, it means that I have reached the end of the tree, right? So from that I can recurse back. So that is the benefit of this. Left and right, they'll both store the address of the left child and the right child, but at the same time, if there is no child present, we can just mark them as null, and they will tell us that okay, you have reached the last node and now you can go back. So this is the end of the tree. This is actually the end of one branch, let's say. This is the end of a one branch, and now you can't go further, just go back. So this is the structure of one node, and you know, we can connect multiple nodes, right? So I'll just store the address of B. Let's just say that the address of B is let's say 4FE3, 4FE2. Okay, so I'm just storing the address of B, and from F, if I just simply move to that particular address, I'll be able to reach B, right? Similarly, if I can store the address of right side, so maybe let's just say 2ACB. Okay, so I'm in my right node in this data structure, in my right side I have the address of the right child, right? So I can also access my right child. I hope this is pretty clear. Since I only need three things. Firstly, what is my value? I'm just talking as a node right now. Okay, what is my value? Second thing, what is the address of my left child, so that I can access that? And then what is the value of my right child, so I can access that. Okay, so this was the code for C++ and C. I think most of you are C++ users, so this will be really helpful for you. And then let's see Python. Okay, so in Python you can use class. I just make a class node. Okay, and after that you can use this init. This is basically the way you define a constructor. The purpose of a constructor is, if you are not familiar with this, is to, you know, initialize the variables. So that is what this is, how you create a constructor in Python. And after that, I'll just do the same thing. Okay, self.data. Self means this. If you know the word this, then self is equal to this. Okay, so self.data will be let's say any this key. Okay, self.data is equal to key, the value. And after that, we can have self.left child, right? So maybe none. Self dot right child, this also may be none. So this is the code for a single data structure, for a single node in Python. Okay, so if you're, I don't know how many of you are Python users there, but for you out there, this is the code how to create a single node. Okay, this is a single node, and after that, you know, we can create multiple nodes and just store their value on the respective places, and we will be able to successfully access them. Okay, so now the last language, I think Java. These three are the most popularly used language, right? I don't think most of you use Ruby or Scala, right? So Java is completely so class node, right? And after that, how do we start? Let's just say maybe another key. Okay, the value that you want to insert, so int key. And after that, you have two types, node left and node right, right? So this, the purpose of this is just to store the value of the left and right child. And after that, we have our constructor. We have our constructor node, right? And in this, you can just take any value from the user. You can take any value from the user, and you can assign the values here. So in the similar way that we were using Python, right? We were just giving the values. We are just doing that same thing here. So very sorry for that. Okay, so it will be like this: key equals to item, and you can just say that key equals to item, and maybe left is equal to right is equal to null. So in Python, this is how you You can simply initialize a single node. Okay, so I hope this is pretty clear to you. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask them in the comment section. Okay, I'll just answer them all. Now we have made one node F. Every single node will have three parts. Firstly, its data. Second, its left side. Third, and then its right side. So I'll just store the value of its left child in this in its left value, and that way I can simply iterate to it. And when don't worry, we'll just, you know, I'll tell you how to insert values, I'll tell you how to, you know, print all these values. But since this is just the first lesson, I'm just telling you how to create a simple node. Okay, so now we'll be talking about the properties of a tree that will, of a binary tree rather, to be specific, that will help you in solving different question of binary, different question of binary trees. Okay, so the first property that you must keep in your mind is that the maximum number of nodes at any level L of a binary tree is 2 raised to the power of L. Okay, so the max nodes at level L is 2 raised to the power of L. Okay, so this is actually how you represent it in Python. So it means that 2 raised to the power of L. Okay, so what do I mean by this is, firstly, for that you need to know what a level is, right? So this is the 0th level, this is the first level, this is the second level, and this is the third level. Okay, so the root, where the root lies, that is known as the 0th level. After that, similarly, as we keep moving on downwards, we have 1, 2, and 3, right? So what I mean by this is that maximum node at level L is 2 raised to the power of L. So just for an assumption, let's just say that suppose that this G can have at max two childs, right? So let's just say that he has another child here. Now, how many total number of nodes will he present level 2? There will be 4. And that is exactly what it wants to say, that the maximum nodes, not the minimum, but the maximum nodes that it can have is 2 raised to the power of 2. That will be 4. So the maximum nodes that I can have at level 2 is 4. I can't exceed that count, right? Similarly, for this level 3, the maximum nodes that I can have is what? 8. So if A has 2 childs, and this node that I just created, if this also has 2 childs, right? And even 2 has another child, so the total number of nodes that will be present here, they will be 8, right? So that is what is the meaning of this property. Right now you'll be thinking that, well, yeah, that is pretty obvious, but you know, it becomes really useful when you are solving questions. Okay, so the next property that we have is that in a binary tree with n leaves, it has at least log 2 l plus 11. Log 2, let's say that it has l leaves, and the levels will be equal to log 2 l plus 1, right? So the total number of leaves that this particular tree has is, right, 4. It has 4 nodes. So if I just take log 2 of 4 plus 1, 5, what will be the value that I get? It will be log 2, 4 plus 1, so 2 point something. If I just take the int value, I'll get 2, right? So it is saying that it can have at least, it will have at least 2 levels. However, we have here 3 levels, but it is only saying that it can have at least 2 levels, and that is true, right? So even though they can, currently we have 3 levels, but it is only saying that at minimum we can have 2 levels, but don't worry, we have 3 levels, so that is also pretty much fine. But just for an assumption take, that this at max, how many leaves can this particular tree have? It can have 8 leaf nodes, right? So if I just put that in the formula, log 2 8 plus 1, log 2 9, it will give me what? It will give me 3 point something. Removing the redundant value, I'll get a value of 3, right? So that is exactly my answer here. I am having only 3, I'll have at least 3 levels, and I do have 3 levels, right? So that is what is the meaning of this property. So this was the basics of a binary tree, and from the next video onwards, we'll be moving on to the insertion part, how to, you know, do a DFS, how to do a BFS, how to, you know, do a in order, pre order, and post order traversal. So we'll do all that. So just, you know, stay tuned, and thank you.